When the February 15th, 2017 Budget Committee meeting, and the first order of business is a discussion of the membership. As you will notice, we have several members that appear to be missing. That's because we found out via an RSA that Budget Committee members were limited if they were also on the Planning Board. So we could only have two people on the planning, on the Budget Committee, who are also on the Planning Board. And we found this out late yesterday, so we had to meet at 6:30 and quickly get two people to resign. And I want to thank them for their service. They're in the audience with us.
Woo-hoo!
It's Eric Pyre and Jules Harvey. Because we could not hold a meeting until those two letters of resignation came in, believe it or not, because it was illegal to have that.
Was this a new RSA?
No, it was published in 2011. It was not. We didn't find out about it till yesterday. No one knew about it. No one had ever come out up before. Catherine Dawson was looking for something else and found this. So that's why we had to...
Look at the RSAs, Catherine.
So anyway, that's what happened. So we're now ready to go through the other thing. And the first order of business is our meeting minutes from the last meeting. Has everybody had a chance to review those?
Mm-hmm.
All right, I'll entertain a motion to accept them.
Motion to accept them. Tilton Budget Committee meeting minutes of February 8th, 2017.
Is there a second?
I'll second that.
Any discussion? All in favor? Aye.
Aye.
All opposed? And one abstention. Okay. The next that we're going, the thing that we're going to is the, are the warrant articles. Oh, we have another. We have a new member who's applied for tonight. It's Arthur DeMoss, and so he needs to be sworn in. We'll swear him in after the.
I'll make a motion to appoint Arthur DeMoss as replacement.
And I'll second it. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Okay. Welcome, Arthur.
Woo!
Thank you, Arthur.
All right, so that we have to give to Joyce.
You guys sit up here now.
That one's
any questions from the audience, direct them to Arthur.
Yeah.
Arthur will be happy to answer any questions you have. And we may be here till 10 o'clock tonight while he tries to figure out what they are. But we do have RSAs available.
Officially swear in, Arthur. Okay, so I guess stand up, raise your right hand. I, Arthur DeMoss, Jr., do solemnly swear that I will faithfully and impartially discharge and perform all the duties incumbent on me as a Budget Committee member to the best of my abilities, agreeable to the rules and the regulations of this Constitution and to the laws of the State of New Hampshire, so help me God.
He needs to fill out the back of that.
It's filled out.
Yep.
Yes.
Can I implore anyone who knows somebody who would like to join the committee, please
still
ask.
Openings.
Yes, there are openings.
Yes. And I think we need somebody with the last name with the name starts with a D, but I'm not sure about that. We'll have to check. We'll have to check that out and publish it on the website. Done. I see the head is being bowed. He must be praying.
Oh.
All right. So we're going to move right along and go over the warrant articles, and I think all of you have a copy. Everybody in the audience have a copy of the warrant articles.
We're just going to the next page.
And yeah, and we're going to start. The only ones that we have to recommend or not recommend are the ones involving money. All right, so we are going to start with Article 10.
No, Article 8.
I'm sorry, Article 8. I'm sorry, Article 8. It says to see if the town will vote to approve the cost items included in the collective bargaining agreement reached between the Tilton Selectmen and the Tilton Police Union, NEPBA Local 29, which calls for the following increases in salaries and benefits at the current staffing level. For the year 2017 to 18, $24,011. the years 2018 to 2019, $23,058. For the years 2019 to 2020, $18,989. For an entire contract total of $66,058. And further to raise and appropriate the sum of $24,011 for the current fiscal year, such sum representing the additional costs attributable to the increase in salaries and benefits required by the new agreement over those that would be paid at current staffing levels. This amount does not include the operating budget. It's not included in the operating budget. This article is or is not recommended by the selectmen and is or is not recommended by the budget committee. Majority vote required. All right, is there any discussion?
So all this total, none of these are in the budget?
In the operating budget, because we didn't have the contract until it was just signed.
I'll make a motion.
$24,000 and it's not in the budget.
Entire contract of $66,058.
Just this year.
$24,000. Just the first year, John.
Okay, $24,011.
And I'll second that as a discussion. All right. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed? So, John, you want to read Article 9? We'll go around this way and then.
Okay. Article 9 says to see if the town will vote and raise and appropriate the sum of $35,000 to be added to the Highway Equipment Capital Reserve Fund established in 2012. This appropriation is not included in the operating budget. And is or isn't recommended by Selectmen and Budget Committee.
All right, I'll make a motion to bring it to the floor for discussion.
Okay, so $35,000 is addition, it's adding to the capital reserve? So
yes.
What is the capital reserve right now?
It's around
$70,078.
$70,078.
Yeah, and this is something that we do every year.
Okay. I think you've been through that.
Yeah. And for the public to know and anyone who doesn't know, the reason for these capital reserve funds and putting money into them every year is so that the town doesn't get walloped with one big one and they didn't realize there's money in there so that it could be spread over multiple years.
Okay. Any?
Is that the amount we came up with last year? Where did we come up with these numbers?
It's the same as last year, isn't
same,
it, Tim?
It's exactly
been,
the same.
We've been
as
running
last year.
That amount.
We've been doing it every year.
Yeah.
From, mm-hmm. I lived in town. So. All right. Is there any further discussion about it?
I'll make a motion.
Yes, we'll make a motion.
Well, I'll make the motion then. I'll make a motion to approve Article 19 by the Budget Committee.
Article 9
by the Budget Committee.
I'll second.
All in favor?
All right.
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Okay. Arthur, you want to read Article 10?
Right into the microphone.
Let me just read it.
Oh, he has a cold, so we'll give him a cold. All right. Stan, would you like to?
Article 10, to see if the town will vote to raise and appropriate the sum of $74,000 to be added to the town roads, bridges, and sidewalks capital reserve fund. This appropriation is not included in the operating budget.
For discussion, I'll make a motion to bring it to the floor. Is there a second?
Second.
All right. Any
is this
comments?
The same as last year?
Yes.
The difference is last year we converted it into being the same fund. We include sidewalks on the same.
That's right.
Combine the monies. That's why it might look a little more than it did 2 years ago.
Last year, $101,000. Normally it would be this 65 plus 9 sidewalks.
All right, any comments? Questions? I make a motion for the Budget Committee to accept Article 10. It's written. addition of $74,000 to be added to the Town Roads, Bridges, and Sidewalks Capital Reserve Fund. Is there a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye, opposed? Okay. Christine, you want to talk?
Article 11, to see if the town will vote to raise and appropriate the sum of $20,000 to be added to the revaluation capital reserve fund established in 2002. This appropriation is not included in the operating budget. This article is not recommended by the selectmen and is not recommended by the budget committee. Majority vote required.
Okay, is there any discussion? Make a motion for the budget committee to accept Article 11, to raise and appropriate the sum of $20,000 to be added to the revaluation capital reserve fund established in 2002. All those in favor?
I'll second that.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Okay. Article 12, to see if the town will vote to raise and appropriate the sum of $31,300 for the purpose of developing a schematic design and total project construction cost estimate for a new Tilton Police Station. This project includes architectural services, wetlands determination, and geotechnical investigation. The final report and recommendations will be presented at the 2018 town meeting. This article is not included in the operating budget, and this is one that is new to all of us. All right, so I'll make a motion to bring it to the floor for discussion. Is there a second?
Second.
All right.
Is this for the current location or a new location? What do we know about this?
Do you think maybe we could table our decision on this till after the hearing so that all the information's presented to everybody at once might be...
Okay.
So I'll make a motion to table till...
I second that.
After the hearing.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye, opposed? All right.
That was just to table it for now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because we haven't heard it, and the selectmen will present their information on it. All right, the last article is to see if the town will vote to raise and appropriate the budget committee recommended sum of $5,065,777 for general municipal operations.
Yeah, what number?
That's the selectmen's number. You guys have to come up with your recommended number for the operating budget.
I have that number.
Okay, John?
Using the amount of the sewer, which would be on the...
All right, so what?
Table that.
Okay.
Table it.
Okay, so I'll make a motion to table it till after the public hearing. Is there a second?
A second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Right.
Okay, all opposed? Okay. And that's it for the articles. Any comments from the audience?
I have questions. Are we not allowed to ask right now, or is that going to be...
No, you can ask from the budget committee.
Okay.
Why we voted the way we did.
Yep, so for one, can you just tell me when the fiscal year begins and ends for the town?
It's a calendar year.
Yeah.
So why is a contract for 3 years for the police department on Article 8? Why is it a 3-year contract and not just a 1-year?
Would you explain that?
Yeah.
It's a 3-year contract, but we only vote on 1 year, because next year, they could actually turn down the contract. It has to be approved every year, and it's automatically in the budget.
3-year contract.
Period?
It's a 3-year contract, period. A 3-term year. But they begin in July. Their contract is July to July, July to June 30th. So the first year you vote on at town meeting is the year that affects the budget. So this year, the year that it affects the budget is the $24,000. The following year, it automatically goes into the budget, so that you'll see it automatically in the budget. But the first year of the contract, the town meeting has to accept the in it as a warrant.
It is typically a three-year contract that you guys vote on.
And it's something that we don't find out about until the negotiations with the union take place, and there are representatives on the select board. Selectman Constantino and Selectman Fogg were the representatives this year, and then there's an attorney, and then there are representatives from the police department as well, the union. Okay? Yes? Lynn?
You answered my question. This is a negotiated term, so, I mean, we could throw the town into great turmoil by not passing this warrant article, am I right?
Yes. Because it's a contract.
I think they would, wouldn't they have to go by last year's contract until it was resolved?
Yes.
If the police body didn't accept it.
If the legislative body didn't accept it.
Yeah.
Correct.
Then the old contract would carry over? Would there any automatic raises in there?
We would have to renegotiate. We'd have to go back to the table.
So it would be just completely flat funded?
Correct.
I'm not recommending. I like recommends.
Scott?
Jane, under the police, underline 0178.210.6. FICA, why did it cut the job from $7,000 to $11,100?
All right, let me just mute Scott.
What was the last number?
Yes. I'll defer to Kim.
Addition of personnel in group one. So the hiring of prosecutor, our attorney prosecutor is originally police. So we maintain routine for that. So that increased FICA quite a bit.
So did the retirement, Tim, did the retirement went down because of that also? Because the prosecutor used to be in retirement group two, right?
Well, there were other personnel changes, but so there was hiring as well to replace positions. So the net, I'd have to look at the net.
The net is a plus?
So no, it was a reduction. It did result in a small reduction.
About $2,000? If I'm looking here, the numbers are...
Four, five.
I think it's more than that, isn't it?
There's about $6,000 off group retirement two versus the $4,000 group two. About six on the FICA.
Yeah, group one went up $6,000.
Yeah, okay.
Well, one was salaried and one was... The new one is, the new prosecutor is a salaried position, is that correct?
That's correct.
And the former prosecutor was an hourly, is that correct?
That's right, but the former prosecutor was a group two, because of their designation, and the attorney prosecutor is a group one. So the retirement percentage is less in group one, much higher in group two.
So it's about a $4,000 increase.
Five, four, five. Okay. Any other questions or comments?
I have a question on sanitation curbside contract. Where did we actually determine that final number of $139.50? Isn't that contract still up in the air, or is that...
No, the contract is finalized. We changed providers. We went from Casella to Pinardville.
We got the containers.
Okay.
Okay. Any other comments or questions? All right, yes, Scott?
I'm not gonna get out of that easy, Jane. Can you explain to me what's going on in the land use under the town planner? We never had a town planner before.
That's correct.
And I see the lines going from $45,000 to $60,008 for this coming year.
That's correct.
And I also see that there's another line underneath, and I don't know if you put that, it's a land use technician, I don't, and that's never been there before, it's a blank line in the past year.
That's correct. We have a new town planner. We had Doris Hassan, who was an assistant in the land use office, and recently he was promoted to a town planner, which from the time he was hired on, that was the plan, was to eventually have the town planner. And he has recommended that at some point we hire a technician who would do things like part-time technician at an hourly rate to do things like filing, answering the phone, finding maps for people who come in, helping people fill out forms.
Data entry,
because Dari's plans are to have everything on in data entry on the computers before long. So that's what that when the selectman made that decision, 2 months ago? For the town planner was what, 6 months ago maybe? And the technician was, I'd say within the month, last month.
Is this the same what we talked about last year at the town meeting? It was brought up by a couple different individuals about last year, brought up about changing positions midstream and then coming to the townspeople, and you've already made the decision and already increased the lines. Yes. I think we talked about, we asked that that be done at town meeting instead of being done before town meeting. I know we couldn't force that, but there was, I think it was the former Belknap County Attorney that got up and made the presentation and asked that, you know, for the fairness to the people, that to bring it to the townspeople instead of the governing body just going ahead and changing or changing the title of a position and then giving an increase. I mean, we're looking at, Jane, we're looking at this, and between these two lines, we're looking at a $24,000 increase in these two lines as taxpayers. And yet, you're saying it's already a done deal with the town planner, that was done a couple months ago. Correct me if I'm wrong. That's what you just stated.
That's what I just stated. That's correct. And I'm going to defer to Selectman Constantino because it was a decision made by the selectman.
I think we had a discussion about that.
That you're correct, Scott. We did. We had. We changed his position in July, in the beginning of July, the end of July, from land use
coordinator
to town planner. We worked on his job description, he would be the department head, work under code enforcement, we'd be working under him. Hopefully with that would determine that there would be a lot more documentation, a lot more accountability, and a lot more efficiency in the department. With that, with the job descriptions and the primary duties and secondary duties being revamped, we looked at hiring a technician, a land use technician, for the reasons that Jane explained, data entry, doing a lot of work in the office part-time. It's a part-time position, 20 hours a week, from $13 to $16 an hour in that range. We did not hire that person. We put that in the budget contingent, and the motion was made contingent upon passing a town meeting. So we are bringing it to the legislative body to vote on.
On the part-time, but not the full-time, not the town planner.
He's always been full-time. It's just
But it has. If we look at the line, Pat, and I'm going to direct my comment back to the chair of the budget. Jane, if we look at the line, and you look at the average from 3 years, 13 through 15, to $33,000 average on the budget. We look at the line now, we've doubled that from 13 through 15, the average, and we look at it now, it's doubled almost. It's up to $60,000. And as a taxpayer, I'm concerned about that. That's a huge increase in that amount of time. And it was already a full-time position before it became a town planner, and now, not only have we seen an increase in that line for that one position, they're saying they've changed again, just as it was before, they've changed the title of the position, and now they're looking at putting a part-time underneath that position again, and it's just the staff in the town hall keeps increasing on us dramatically. And it's at a point where the taxpayer, we have to ask why. Why? Because we don't have the growth we had back in the 90s when Exit 20 was booming. We don't have the houses being built. So as a taxpayer, I'm questioning why. Why are we looking at all of this growth within the planning department when we have paid in the past and we have never implemented a impact fees in this town, even though we went through Lakes Region planning and spent money out of our budget for multiple years, and that still has not been done. We do not have fees for when these companies come in here that they're going to pay. It's a free-for-all. And I think that's shameful for the taxpayer not to be represented in a better fashion with that. We paid, and I remember one year, it was $10,000 was in the budget for Lakes Region planning to put a master plan together in this town. And I don't think that ever got completed. And, you know, it's sad when we're taking taxpayers' dollars that they work hard to pay the taxes and not being prudent with that money. And here we see this line going up double within a five-year window. You just can't continue it.
First of all, the Lakes Region Planning was hired to help with the CIP. Lakes Region Planning, I think we spent approximately $5,000, at which time they came back to us and said, we have interviewed everyone in the town of Tilton. There, at this time, there's no opportunity to have any applications because we have a lot of state roads. We had no subdivisions coming in. That's the kind of thing that the CIP would be used for. So the only thing we had, and we went to all the departments to ask for anything, the police department came back with communications equipment. Correct me if I'm wrong on that, I think. You remember that, Chief Cormier? That was not something that was eligible to use. So for that reason, we did not go with that. And so Lakes Region, we paid them only what work they had done to that point, and I believe it was around $5,000. We had a position in land use, it was primarily a clerical position. They did minutes, handed out forms, and it became apparent, for instance, we have issues with infrastructure in this town. When I say infrastructure, I'm not just talking local roads. I'm talking things like local roads, sewer lines, things of that nature. And we have no one to oversee that. We have areas that could grow. We've had a lot of changes in state law, like accessory dwelling, which is on the ballot this year. State law was passed last year about that. That's not something that a clerical position can work on. We've had cluster housing as a possibility. We have demographics that are changing. We have an apartment complex right now out on Route 3 that, in my opinion, and this is my opinion only, as a planning board person, should never have been built. I think we should build things so that we can be repurposed in the future. For instance, you don't build a townhouse that you're going to continually be able to use it families, because we're an aging population. You need something that may be able to be converted in the future to elderly housing. If that's the case, then building, we should build according to that. But we had no one with any expertise. We have problems with our groundwater. We have problems with when buildings go up, buildings are going on our aquifer. And the person who came into land use initially was doing, continuing to do the clerical work. But there are needs for other things to be done, and I just named some of the things, plans for that as changes occur in the future. So that's why I believe that it was thought that a town planner was the kind of way to go. And if I'm incorrect in that, the select board that's here, please correct me. It's not something that sprung up overnight. It was something that had been thought about for a while to add to the town. I understand your concern, but I think you have to look to the future of the town. And the future of the town is going to depend on protecting our water sources, protecting our groundwater, protecting our river basins. And so that's why a town planner is, I consider, somebody very important to have in town. And I think most towns, even smaller than this, have established that position in the last few years. If the selectman would like to add anything to that?
Good job. Yes. I heard it said that the position was full-time prior to him becoming town planner.
Right.
That's incorrect. It was a part-time position. We were going to lose this individual when the previous individual was the clerical work. They handed out forms and typed up letters. When this guy replaced the other one, we raised up four or five levels in what we were doing, GIS mapping, revamping codes, and started to make headway on things that, quite frankly, were left over from the 90s. Mm-hmm. That you should go in the basement and see what a mess it is down there, because you couldn't find anything down there. And he started to make headway with this stuff. We were going to lose him. So you make him full-time or you lose him and go back to falling behind every single day in that department.
And I think, and this is a person who came from Lakes Region Planning, I think, at one point in time. He has a degree in planning and in protecting the water systems. He has been a real asset on the planning board in hearing cases. And we have a very busy planning board. I also want to point out that one of the things he's done is already raise rates for the code enforcement, and there are plans to raise rates for industrial companies that are coming into the town. So in a lot of ways, that will offset the cost of adding him to the payroll. Joyce?
His name is Darius Hassan. He's been with the town for about 3 years. I just wanted to correct a statement. He was first hired part-time to replace a clerical person that was working 24, 25 hours a week. It was about 2 years ago that the board made him full-time because of the workload, and there's just so much that a planning office, a land use office, and a code enforcement office could do far more than what we were providing with the limited number of hours and the technical expertise that we had. So it was about 2 years ago that Dari went full-time. Since he had gone full-time, over, I don't know, maybe 6 months, past 6 months, we've been doing an analysis of all of the tasks that need to be done in a land use office. And we looked at what's the best way to utilize the skills that we have. Like our code enforcement officer, he should be out there inspecting and enforcing codes. That's what you're paying the person for their skill and their time to do. You're paying a planner to do all the things that Jane had said. And in the meantime, you have your regular daily office functions where every single department in this town including the fire department, the water department, the sewer department, the Department of Transportation, all of these other agencies, Lakes Region Planning Commission, all interact, interface, the selectman's office. I'm in there every day pulling maps and things and trying to get information, helping someone that comes in the door. They want to know, geez, I have a problem with this and that. Well, where do you go to get the information? You go to the land use office. So on top of that, we've been trying to automate everything with the help of Tim, because thank God we have his technical skills. And it's like, whew, we're in the 21st century now. So all of this has been, we've spent a lot of time on putting together the proposal, setting up who's going to report to who, having the code enforcement officer report to the planner, and then having the, and then we tested it. We had an intern from Winnisquam Regional High School come in to start just doing some of the daily clerical tasks, mostly scanning and typing, you know, doing the clerical things that, you know, you don't really pay your code enforcement officer and your planner to do. On top of that, especially with manufactured housing, because that quite a bit of new manufactured housing units come into town, a lot of inspection time and reports need to be done, and these reports have to be retrievable. And so, you know, you've got to increase some hours somewhere.
So who's been doing it until now?
Pardon me?
Who's been doing it until now, 3 years ago?
Oh, Dari and Al.
So
between the two of them, but just that the work demand.
$60,000 from 33 for no difference in work, is that what you're telling me?
No, we're doing more work.
No, that's not at all what she implied, Lynn.
No.
I mean,
we're doing
these,
more work.
But I'm saying all of these things were being done before. No, you were helping people find that.
No, they weren't. That was the problem. They weren't getting done.
Tax maps when they came into town hall?
No, but it takes time.
It was the bare minimum.
Takes time to do that. That office interfaces with so many people. So here you have a person that's interfacing with all these agencies, with, you know, people coming in wanting services, town departments in there wanting services, planning board and zoning board wanting services, attending their meetings, preparing everything for their meetings, which I think it's like the best preparation that I've ever seen for to make them more productive and helpful. Excuse me, and then doing minutes. I mean, he'll still be doing the minutes, but don't worry, he'll still be doing the minutes of the meetings. It just makes sense to have a professional, and we looked at other planning offices in the surrounding communities, and it's time that Tilton, that we get our act together and do what we're supposed to be doing.
What other communities did you look at, Joyce?
Belmont primarily.
Sanberton also has had a town planner for a long time.
And I think some of the areas that we really need to beef up on is the reporting requirements, the record keeping, the enforcing codes, and doing inspections. And so that will free up the code enforcement officer to be able to do more of that instead of doing clerical work. Because that's a more technical position rather than a clerical position.
Okay.
And it should have been a technical position I mean, as a planning board person, I think that was necessary for a long time. Because a lot of times we had a lot of questions that no one could answer, and we weren't really knowledgeable enough to give the correct answers. And it's been very helpful to the planning board. But Scott, I know that you watch the town website, you watch the planning board, not the planning board, you watch the budget committee, and if the select board also. Dari made a very recently made a presentation that should be on tapes that are probably still up, aren't they, Tim?
Yep.
You might want to listen to that, and we'll give you more.
The fact that I'm sitting here just looking at these numbers, and it is a huge increase. There's an explanation. I think Dari does a nice job. I'm not saying he doesn't, but I'm just saying that when you look at the budget part and you see the numbers, as a citizen, we need explanations. Mm-hmm. And what we asked at the last year, like we had asked the selectmen, I mean, there was a couple of us got up and said just about the same thing, asked them to please, instead of making a change midstream, come to the voters and ask and get it clarified, especially, I know you haven't filled the part-time, so that's what we're talking, what Pat talked about a minute ago, but Dari's position has already been upgraded. And it's the same MO as what was before, that a position, there hadn't been particularly a raise, it had been a change of what the title on the position was, so therefore there was an increase.
And I do know, I want to bring up the fact too to Scott, that a member of the Budget Committee did ask the same questions you did about the presentation that was made at town meeting. Jules Harvey, who had to resign.
Okay.
Yeah.
I know if you take a look on the page, it says estimated 2017 revenue. I don't know if everybody's got that there. It's all like this.
I haven't seen.
If you look in the column, the 2016 budget under line 3230, building permits.
Oh, here it goes.
In 2016, we had a budget that we thought we were just going to get $25,000. At the end of the year of 2016, we had $38,869. So that's like an increase of $13,000 just in building permits last year over what we thought. And then if you go down a little further to 3402.04, land use revenue, in 2016, we thought we were only going to get about $4,000 in revenue. And that would be down here. If you look at the end of the year, we ended up with $13,184. And that kind of shows, like, the last year, things have just been, you may think it's slowing down, but things are getting more difficult. People are trying to get more creative on how they can put things past us. You know, we're not a town that people can pull the wool over our eyes, but they might think that developers can come in here and do it, and it requires somebody with some good expertise to oversee that. And
I don't have that.
Tim might have it.
Before 2016?
Yeah. No, for 2015.
I'm going to yield to Tim if possible.
We have 3 years on the budget, but we don't have 3 years on the revenue.
Yeah. Yeah. So some of the stuff and the things people have been applying for, they've been a little more in-depth to coordinate it all.
I think you, Scott, have been involved in some of our trips to some of our neighboring towns who've been putting things over the aquifer that we have felt shouldn't be done, and we've become a lot more conscious of that. We've become a lot more conscious of water-oil separators. We've become a lot more conscious of alteration of terrain as time has gone on. So I think those are all things that have made us know that we needed to look towards somebody with a little more sophistication than a clerical personnel in that office.
Mm-hmm. Is that increase of $60,000, does that include benefits, or that's just a salary increase?
That's just a salary increase.
So it's like, what, is it like a $5 an hour increase?
I'll defer to Tim. I don't know.
Still chasing down the revenue.
I can say the revenue from 2015 was $34,000 for building permits, before the combination of building permits. $3,1 on building permits and $10,500 for land use income. Thank you, Tim.
Tim, there was a question on the. Did you get the last question? I'm so glad you're here, Tim.
Oh, I'm thrilled.
I have a question for John, being a select board member, and this person being a planner. What are the future plans for the town? Is he working on not just enforcing what we have, getting, is there a plan? Is there a plan to fill the Shaw's building? Is there a plan to build anywhere on exit 20. Is there any future growth of this town other than the possibility of building a police station?
Well, he's not a realtor, first of all, so he won't be filling Shaw's.
Yeah, that's one of the directives is to, you know, get our master plan, you know, done and keep it updated. And as for planning, I think, you know, I'm going to refer to Jane on that because she's been working with Dari on the planning board and, you know, on what's going on and what their directives or what projects are working on.
And I ask you as a select board member, because that's what we were talking about, is the select board saw him as vital because he would have gone and moved on. What are we getting from him other than a guarantee he's going to do the job that he's supposed to? Is there something extra from this person that we would get that we wouldn't get?
Well, knowledge and expertise is key, you know, and
mapping
and the GIS mapping,
work and all that. Maps. He does all that.
Digitizing.
The other thing is, if you've ever been to the DES site where they have one step, so you can go in and you can access all the information. Presently, a lot of our stuff, when people come in for information or research, getting permits to do things, they have to go to all different boards, and a lot of them have time limits that you have to do that within reply or things are approved, such as conservation only gets a certain amount of time to comment. Dari is putting together all that and actually has already implemented quite a bit to make sure that, like, the Conservation Commission gets notified of anything that's coming before the planning board. Before, they didn't get that, so the Conservation Commission would meet once a month and they'd find out that something went through the planning board and they didn't get the opportunity to comment on it, which could cause some, you know, some problems. So that's a lot of the stuff that he's been working on. He's already started to implement and it's been working well. But it's there's a lot more to the different projects that people are proposing around the town. As we get a little more dense, people try and get a little more creative and try variances. And
I have the answer on the hourly.
Mm-hmm.
It was $6.89.
What percentage? Ballpark. $6 from what?
It was a 31.3%. $6.89 over 21.96.
That's one of the main concerns I have. As a budget committee member, a lot of what you hear, and I get it, is, well, we want to keep good people. Of course you want to keep good people. And they say, well, what could we do? You know, if somebody gets a master's degree in this, what, you know, we have to pay so much. Well, we're a small town. You know, that person gets that degree or moves on, you know, maybe they move on to a Concord or a Manchester or Boston, and maybe we can't afford them. Not that, you know, this... So I just want to make sure that the select board came up with a, what are we getting for, what bang are we getting for that buck? What's the return on investment in this money? Is basically what I'm asking for. Is there a plan to build in the future other than we're just collecting money more efficiently and we're keeping...
We're collecting more money.
Yeah.
And the intention is to look to areas of the town that have not been developed, that can be developed. I know as a planning board chair, I've been on him to go out and look at new developments or whatever. He's not been able to do that because he's been sitting there typing or answering calls or completing a form that somebody didn't fill out correctly. Clerical work.
Notices.
And doing notice, sending out notices. Okay? one of the things we talked about just last week was going out to the various industry that's here. For instance, the place that's out on Business Park Drive now, Sea Light. Yeah. Why did they come here? I mean, it's a very, you know, looking at things like that. And that's the sort of thing that Dari plans to do in the future.
That's what I'm asking. That's what I'm looking for. Yeah. What growth are we looking for this? What return on investment do we hope to get other than easier clerical or, you know? How do we get somebody?
I would hope he's not going to be doing clerical work.
How do we get somebody in there? How do we get somebody
I wouldn't
somebody
have recommended
here?
The position
yeah.
or gone along with it. I would have said we could just hire another kid or get another intern from Winnesquam if that's all we were looking for. I don't think that's what we were looking for.
Yeah.
I think as someone said, I think Joyce said it, we wanted to move into the 21st century. And we can only do that if we get people who can help attract industry. We're in an area that's not growing. And the reason it's not growing is because we don't have the talent to go out and bring people in. And I would hope that would be one of the benefits, and the return on the investment is very great in a situation like that.
Low tax base would also.
What metric have you established for evaluating the success of that program?
Of what program?
Tell us whether that
I didn't hire him.
Whoever did. What metric will tell us whether that was a good expenditure or not?
Well, I think we can look and to see what kind of increases and what kind of industry comes into the area.
He just said
that sort of thing.
A real estate agent, so how is he getting anybody coming into the area?
Industry has nothing to do with real estate. That industry, bringing industry in, yes, they might be looking for a building or a piece of land to buy, but that's not like renting a Shaw's. That's what I said. He's not a real estate broker. Yes.
I understand that we're talking about employee in the budget, but I think we've gotten off track here a little bit.
Yeah.
We have a public hearing that was due at 7:30.
All right. Catherine, you had
I was just going to try to answer Steve.
Okay. Scott.
He's already looked at open spaces available for development and is suggesting those possible uses. The planning board was presented by possible cluster development.
Yes.
Proposal, which the town has looked at for years, but nobody ever went forward rather than just suggesting it. So for us to develop those green spaces we have left, and there really aren't that many, cluster development would be the way to go, but we don't have any cluster development regulations. So that's one way that he's looking to the future for those properties.
And we didn't have the regulations for accessory dwellings either, and he put together a beautiful package on that. Scott, I'm sorry, and Pat's right, we are getting...
I have two questions.
Mm-hmm.
First, Ian, on the revenue side,
mm-hmm.
line 3916, why did we bring in 139,680 for the trust transfers to town when we had 750 in the line?
Wait, where's...
Which line?
On revenue.
Those were related to revenue from capital reserve funds for paving and primarily paving. So we brought them from capital reserve and that's where the transfer is in. My second question concerning, you brought it up, Seedlink. They're on a balloon payment loan.
Mm-hmm.
That loan is not, that bond that we took out from 61 Business Park Drive is not secured loan. It's not secured by the building. My concern as a citizen is when that balloon payment's paid, that pays off the bond, that we don't use it for some other revenue or some other expense, I should say. Is that, I don't see that anywhere in here on the revenue when you pay the payments, Tim. Where does that show up?
I do have a plan that's been in place for several years now, looking at that balloon payment and our debt and how our debt will be satisfied by that. But it would. This would be in February of 2018.
Yep.
Is when that's due. So.
And where's the payment? Where does it show it on the record? Where the payment comes in from? The
sale of town property.
Sale of town property. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. All right. Any other comments or questions?
There's I had just a tiny mm-hmm. question. Sorry. Could you find it? It's really inconsequential. What is under Health and Human Services Salary Senior Executive Committee? It's a new line, as I understand it.
I believe that's a stipend.
Or, I mean, who is that?
The executive directors of the senior center.
Committee.
Committee, executive committee. Okay.
Of our senior center?
Hmm?
I thought when we did the senior center, we were told that taxpayer money wasn't going to be there.
That, it's not for the senior center. It's like people on the planning board have a stipend. The executive committee of the senior center get a stipend that was voted in this year. People on the budget committee get a stipend. People, you know, it's a stipend type thing. It doesn't have anything to do with the senior center. It's the volunteers, just like the volunteers on the planning board or whatever.
But that money is specifically for people working at the senior center.
Well, they don't work there. It's the board that governs the senior center.
Well, that's what I mean.
Yes.
They not only work at the senior center, they work throughout the town with the seniors, with elderly, with driving them, with a lot of things. The executive committee do a multiple of things with a multiple of different things, various things throughout the town with seniors. They spend with, there's five executive committee members, and each one of them a minimum of maybe 15 hours a week with the seniors. A minimum of 15 hours a week. And they do, once a month they have a meeting. So I brought this forward to the Board of Selectmen, and I brought it forward to the Budget Committee as well, and they both approved that they would be included in with the town committee. It is a town committee, that they would receive a stipend just like the budget, planning, zoning, parks.
I just have one more question.
You said that last time, Scott. You're shut off.
Can you ask him what the balloon payment is on for the 61 business park driver ceiling? I'll have to dig that up.
I'll never bring up Sea Light again.
Well, you brought it up, sir.
That's what I said. I'll never do it again.
I can post that, if you like, on the website. Please, we've got it out there. I'll have to dig that up.
There's no other questions or anything. I'm going to close the public hearing and
switch over
to the selectmen. Thank you for your patience.
What are you switching over?
The selectmen's. These are their warrant articles.
Are you adjourning or are you coming back to your meeting?
They're not adjourning.
They're not adjourning. I'm just turning it over to them for their hearing on the warrant articles.
You have to make a motion to suspend, Jane.
Oh, I'll make a motion to sustain.
To suspend.
Is there a second? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Okay.
Yeah. No. Stretch your legs.
Who's still here?
Not me.
Sorry to wake you back there.
All right, so. Now, does everybody, do you have any other questions about Article 12, which we tabled?
No.
Anybody? You're satisfied with the fact that we'll know the location?
Mm-hmm. I'm not satisfied with that. I'm not satisfied with a lot of things. When did this come up? When did this plan start?
Well, this is the first time we've seen it as a budget committee.
And that's what we discussed a while ago, is every year, there's the last minute, oh, we really need to build these offices on the stage, or yes, we really need to air condition this room.
The opportunity came up around 2.5 weeks ago.
Mm. Well, no, even earlier than that, because the plan that we have was originally designed for...
No, he's asking when we decide
this one?
To do...
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh,
the plan we had for about 5 years.
Yeah, I know. That's the first year I moved here was when that, that was the first town hall meeting I went to, and that's why I remembered it.
I think what happened is a unique opportunity came up.
Sure.
Or location.
And every year there's a unique opportunity to spend $25,000.
There is.
Every year.
Well, actually,
every time.
Actually,
last minute. And oh my God, we need it.
This is $31,000. And yes, we do need a police station.
I can see.
There's absolutely no doubt in anybody's mind in the town. I don't think about that.
One of the biggest drawbacks that we've had over the years with the police station is location. Whether it would be up here, over there, or all these different places. That's what held everything up for years. And as we know, property keeps going up in price, up, and it's not grand. But when a unique opportunity, a very good opportunity, becomes available, it would be proper to bring it before the town.
Sure.
To allow them.
Sure.
And at that date, at the town meeting, we can tell people about that location, and we'll have a lot more accurate costs for the lot and present it to everybody. Unfortunately, because it's a real estate type thing, it's non-public at this time. I'd love to tell you.
No, in that detail, that's not my point. And my point is when you're selling it at town hall, you could also add to it, interest rates are at a point now that it's a good time to invest in the town. 10 years from now, hopefully interest rates aren't that good, which means the economy is booming and it's a good time to take out a bond. It's a good, my point to my question was that this is this year's last minute, have an opportunity.
Yes, it is.
Bam.
Yeah, it is.
Your office is up. No. Air conditioning up here, we need because, and it's a unique opportunity that we didn't see 6 months ago.
Yes.
And that's annoying every year.
It is.
As a matter of fact, I've made a lot of meetings, medical reasons and family reasons, but I even warned against it. What's going to be this year's last minute, oh my God, we need?
And
this is
that's not, this year's, oh my God,
no,
we need.
But this is not anywhere near to the comparisons you're bringing up with other things.
No, it is a last minute. Oh my God, it is. It's been done for years.
Every year.
But I take offense to what Stan is saying when we say, I really need it. We're not saying to you, I really need this. An opportunity came to us about 4 weeks ago.
Right.
And as soon as 11 o'clock this morning, another opportunity came to us. We are obligated, I feel, as a selectman, to put that out to the legislative body to say, this is an opportunity. Do you want it or do you not want it? I'm not going to stand there and say, we really need this right here, right now. Come on, vote. I'm not going to say that. They already know the needs of the police department. We already know that.
Yeah, we've known it for years.
But
last minute.
To say to me that I've waited last minute to put this out there is just way, way off base. You know, you can say to me
that's
last year.
Bullseye.
You can
it's say not way off base at all.
You can
it's
say
bullseye. And it happens every year. This year happens to be this. We didn't know we needed a police department.
No, we
spent $500,000.
The land was not available at that time.
Exactly.
No. This argument is redundant to this.
Yeah, I'm not arguing the merits of the plan.
Yes, you are.
No, I'm not.
What we need to do is come back
here. I don't remember asking for your opinion on it.
It's here in front of us now. Okay? And your point, I think, has been well taken.
Okay.
And we do know that that has happened in the past. I don't think last year it was that room. Last year it was the...
It was air conditioning last year.
No, it was the church.
Yeah,
the church. The engineers.
The woman went and sold the thing out from under us.
Okay, but anyway, this is what we have. This is what we have to deal with tonight. So, are there any comments or questions other than the fact that this is our gotcha for the year?
Yeah.
Last minute gotcha.
Yeah.
Any other comments?
Just that if we did not bring this up, I think we would be negligent in doing a disservice to the town, because at town meeting 2 years from now, they'd say, well, you know, we got to do this now. Well, we had a place, but we didn't tell you about it. This is important to get this one out to the town. I don't like spending money. I I'd rather not do it. But this literally came up in the last day, okay. 24 hours.
I'll take your word for it that this did happen to come up right at the end. Again.
Yep.
I'll take your word for it. You seem like an honest guy.
Perfect storm.
I'll take your word for it. Okay. Yeah. I'm just pointing out that this is this year's gotcha. This is this year's. I'm just pointing it out. Fact, no fact. Yes. Take it, leave it. Okay. The merits of it may or may not. I'm just pointing out the fact.
Yeah. Point well taken.
Okay.
All right. Any other discussion? All right. I'll make a motion to accept Article 13 to see if the town will vote.
Oh, 12.
To,
12.
12. Okay. I was getting ready to say the 5 million. to see if the town will vote to raise and appropriate the sum of $31,300 for the purpose of developing a schematic design and total project construction cost estimate for a new Tilton police station. This project includes architectural services, wetlands determination, and geotechnical investigation. Final report and recommendations will be presented at the 2018 town meeting. This article is not included in the operating budget. Is there a second?
I'll second that.
All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed?
No.
One? No. Okay. All right. Now the last thing we have to discuss is the sewer budget. I have my papers all straight here, and they're so messed up now.
And I don't have my papers because I had to run here.
I don't think I have.
They
my
gave
copy.
Us their budget stuff.
And I don't think Arthur does.
Yeah, there was no need.
I'm going to need to look at yours.
Do you have a copy of the
suit
budget?
Yeah, because I just ran here from the highway.
Yeah. Here's Arthur's signed.
Man, you need it too, right?
Okay, I don't want that to
get
lost.
I don't have any good info on it.
Yeah, it was a couple meetings ago. She made some copies.
We have to figure out a term for him.
You didn't cross out budget.
I've got one.
He just told that I don't want it to get lost.
We don't want to cross out.
Okay.
I had two copies, and they only brought one.
I will share.
Yeah, because they gave us a couple years of their budget. And these are dollar figures. And
clerk's counter. I don't want to eat any chocolate.
She's making some coffee.
It's so good.
Yeah, because Stan, we both don't have ours. And he doesn't have it.
Peanuts.
Here, I have.
As long as you're not allergic to them.
Oh, she's got one.
Yeah, I got this whole thing, this whole pack.
So, Catherine, only two now because Stan's got one. So, one and one.
Yeah.
Third temple.
This out.
Yeah, see, this is mine. I was just talking about
table. Oh, okay.
And then all the increases down there.
Yeah.
One in particular. Actually, they had one where this only shows 16. They gave us a couple years.
I got three just in case.
Yeah, see, you don't have this one. 13, 14.
Oh. Whatever.
What did I do?
Do you want me to put it over here?
Well, there's no date.
This one's yours.
Yeah.
It's just a copy.
I'm a numbers. I got to see everything. Author.
What is this?
Sign.
Arthur Sang.
Yep, same one.
No, that's selectmen up here.
Just sign right there, budget.
Pat, can you do me a favor? All right. Okay. Discussion, comment?
Yeah, didn't they give us, didn't you have a couple years on here?
Yeah, there's a whole package. There's the whole package.
This one says 13.
Oh, I don't have the packet that you have.
Thank you.
All right, I'll share.
All right.
Okay. This one is 16 to 17. In that packet, we'll show other years in there.
All right. Broken down in the sheets, okay, so this is the 16.
This is new to Stan and Arthur.
He should write his name.
This is the 16.
Yeah.
Okay, and here's the proposed 17.
Plus the reserve fund.
Yeah, there's a whole packet of stuff in here. Okay.
So it's level funding from last year?
Yes.
How many other departments level funded?
None.
Are any in discussion?
Not happening.
I got a question. Do your lines have GPSs?
Back in 2011, they changed state law and they were required to become co-permittees of the wastewater treatment plant. The requirements was mapping. So I developed a GIS system and our lines are mapped through GIS.
Okay. Any comment, any discussion? Oh, okay, sorry. We got two people that have to look at it because they weren't here. No popcorn for the committee?
Judy took it with her.
No, she's got it right back there.
You're hiding.
I have no other questions.
That's not good.
Looking at the end of the payroll, it says 62,280, and it's going up by an additional $5,000 next year.
Where's that?
There's another $5,000 in increases that are going to be going out next year. And that's for just from June through, or is it retroactive to January 1st? If this budget passes.
I didn't hear the question.
Why is the payroll up?
Huh?
Why is...
Because he's talking quietly.
Can you hear me now?
That's better.
I was looking at the, I know we had a copy of the 2015. I know that we had a raise in payroll then. So the 2016 reflects a raise. But then we're looking at another $5,000 in payroll increases just for 2017. And does that cover for the whole calendar year, or is that just from the date of the town meeting or
you know, what period is that?
Payroll line is for the year.
From January 1st through December? Right, yeah. So that's over the whole year.
We still are up in the air, John, on sewer meter readings. We're trying to work with the water district, however, it's still cheaper for us to hire someone to do it.
Do you hire somebody for the Lochmere district? Or?
No, Lochmere provides it to us.
Kenachuk
provides it to us.
So you guys don't have to pay for somebody to meet?
Kenachuk, I believe it's free. Lochmere has a nominal fee.
If the water company takes it over, now they'll do the billing too, though?
No.
No?
No, the $600.
Well, that's if you want to quadruple what they've given us for a quota, so yeah. I think the billing was $11,000 to handle billing.
I don't know. We had it somewhere.
Yeah, you guys had it. I only saw it from you guys. I don't think we ever received it.
The arrangement that's on the table with the water district is for us to purchase their meter readings for $600 a quarter. We pay $375 a quarter for somebody to read the meter. And even if
we pay the
water district the $600 a quarter, there are still 55 meters on the east side that would have to be read that are not in the Kenachuk of the Lochmere Water District system. They have water meters on their well water, which is an option to having them.
Oh, so
it's cheaper and better.
Here it is. I got it.
I have a question for ballpark figures. Approximately number of residents with the service, has it gone up, down, or pretty much the same as last year?
I think it's been pretty steady. There's, let's see, there's 352. No, these are meters. Johanna would have to tell us that. I just have meter figures.
I would say we've added over the past year probably 40 accounts.
So ballpark the same.
Yeah, unless we do a sewer project, there's only a few that we might add that would be on existing lines that never connected but now want to.
So I'm confused because you said that they're charging $600 a quarter for meter reading only?
That's what they would charge us for.
Okay, I mean, they would charge you that. But if they did the billing and all for you.
We don't have a price for that.
I do. I mean, well, this is, I don't, it's not for you, but it's what they charge Northfield. And didn't he tell us that it would be the same?
We didn't get that from the meeting we had with them on December 5th. That was not discussed.
This is what? Tilton Northfield Water.
Can I comment on the whole Tilton Northfield thing? I would like to make you guys aware that Tilton and Northfield are very different sewer systems. And I'm not sure that the water company is aware of this. Northfield has no pump stations and about 3 miles of pipe.
I'm sorry, I can't. Tilton
and Northfield have very different sewer
systems. No, that part I got, but you were talking about
talking about what?
Then you went on to explain.
Northfield has about 3 miles of pipe. It's all gravity fed. Okay. Everyone in Northfield that is on sewer are on Tilton Northfield Water District. Tilton has about 12 miles of pipe. We've got 11 main pump stations and 40-something grinder stations, which are individual pump stations. We've got it spread out through town. Over one-third of my customers are not on Tilton Northfield Water District. So I don't think that you're getting an accurate... If you look at the price that they're charging Northfield and then the price that they proposed to Tilton, what they pretty much did was double the price, saying, well, we've got about twice the amount of users in Tilton. You can't do that with sewer. That's not the way it works.
If you try to have the water district do it, you're going to split up, because unless they hire more people or send people out of their district to read my meters, you're still having somebody do it on the staff. So I just want you to be aware that Tilton and Northfield sewer-wise are very, very different communities, and you cannot compare the two. And if that is what the water district is trying to sell you, that it's the same thing, they're wrong, and they don't know what they're talking about.
Well, I was going not so much by the water systems, but by what services they said they would provide. And it wasn't just meter reading, because I asked, because they said they would be willing to do meter reading, do the billing.
On people who are not on the water district?
I don't know, I'd have to...
Yeah, well, I think that...
Again, that wasn't discussed at our meeting with them.
Considering Tilton the same as Northfield, and I'm telling you, the sewer systems are extremely different.
I have a copy of the minutes of the meeting we went to.
Yeah.
That was not discussed with the sewer commission. Well, they discussed it with the budget committee. They neglected to discuss it with the sewer commission.
Well, no, this was just sent...
A letter.
To the budget committee?
Well, it was sent to me. It was sent from the water company.
Wasn't sent to the sewer commissioners, so, like, you know, hard to comment.
Well, no, but I thought that's what they had covered with you guys.
No, like I said, I've got the minutes right here. You can see it was not discussed.
Okay, well, that was just a question I had. Because, and you say that Penn took water, does your Lockmere? Because we were told I thought we were told there wasn't any.
Penichuk, there's 28 residents on the Penichuk water system.
Yeah.
They supply the readings for free.
Okay.
There's 41 in the Lockmere Water District. We pay a dollar a reading, so we pay $41 a quarter for those readings.
Okay.
Now, the other thing you should know is, like I said, Penichuk gives us sewage for free. We asked the water district, it's public information, at the meeting on December 5th, they said no. That's non-public information.
What's that?
And it's right here in the minutes. Scott Davis argued with me, saying that it's non-public information. So my question is, if it's non-public information, how can you sell it?
Sell what, the information?
The meter reading. You can't give it to us on the 91A, like Penichuk does. How can you sell it to us?
Well, I think it's a proprietary type thing, right? Because they...
Penichuk gives meter readings to us for free. It's public information.
Well, I don't know if they pay...
So how can you sell non-public information?
If they're paying payroll employees to collect it, I mean, if... I'm not sure.
Right here.
I'm not sure either.
That's my question.
Well, I just was asking. I wanted to
unless
clarify that.
Unless the reasonable cost to make copies of, or to...
Scott Davis stated that he refutes that his electric meter readings and utility are not public records. He stated in that meeting, emphatically, that they were it was non-public information and could not provide it to us under 91A.
So how is that matter to the budget committee?
I was asking.
Been here, but this is the second round of why aren't we basically partnering with the water district? It's not cheaper.
Right.
And I don't understand why we keep going.
Well, I guess my concern is you've got one person doing accounts receivable and accounts payable with no auditor. That's a concern.
We're audited every year.
You are? What auditor? Oh, okay.
Of course we are.
Okay. What auditing firm do you use?
Same as the town.
Okay.
Jane, if we have them do their billing, we still have to do billing for a good chunk of our customers, so it's not a cost savings. We're adding more to our costs.
Okay.
Yeah.
We're trying to keep us as cheap as...
No, I understand that. I didn't realize that they wouldn't do all your customers. I was not aware of that. I thought that that's what they were saying that they could do.
I believe at the last meeting, I stated we'd still have to have somebody reading meters.
The question on the actuals on 2016, was that for the full year?
Yeah.
On this report? So level funding would even be above what actual was.
Does this include the final payment to...
It's unaudited, so the auditor will make adjustments for year end.
We didn't spend $93,647 in 16, and we're asking for the same level budgeting. So the 93 went back into that reserve? Is that reserve fund?
The problem we run into is dealing with the state of New Hampshire with the treatment plant. Yeah. They are not consistent in their billing. We've got three or four lines, I think. And every now and then they skip, and then they make it up in another year. And so we do our best to try to budget it, but we're not going to pay it until they send us the bill.
Is that in revenues or expenses?
That's our expenses, paying for the treatment.
Okay. What line is that?
NHDSWRBP.
That's a, there's like four categories.
Oh, all of
there's
them?
There's admin, O&M,
cap
charges, replacement fund.
Let me just tell you that the cap charges have over doubled over the past 2 years, and what that is it covers projects at the plants. We had a UV disinfection project. We've done the switch gear replacement. So what happened was there was a lot of grant funding in the early 70s where the state came in and gave towns a bunch of money to develop wastewater treatment plants and collection systems.
That was here.
But it's only 3,000 more.
2,000.
It's only 3,000 more.
Yes,
2014 numbers.
You know, the treatment plant went in 82, so.
It seems like every year we're asking for 440, 440, 460, 460. And each year it's 348 actual,
93,000.
450 actual, 350 actual. Every year we're asking for 450, and only 1 year do we actually hit that.
Yep.
But that is different than this actual.
This is 15.
Okay.
I think that's 16. What effect would it have to the sewer commission if we did the same as actual for 16 for 17? Besides, I know the billing of the... Just
if
that.
If we had a significant failure in the infrastructure here, which is the older part of town.
Well, that would come out of that 700,000, right?
No, because it's not in the budget. We'll be over the line item. Whatever you set for the budget, that's going to be our number.
So you're padding your budget for disasters?
I thought that's why you had the reserve fund balance.
Yeah, what is this $800,000 here, then?
That is to cover the, what you guys don't understand is none of our budget is coming through taxation. It's all user fees, so if you're not on sewer, you're not even contributing to it.
As we explained before, we're looking...
Except for the betterments.
If something goes wrong and it turns out to be a betterment and we add on to it, it ends up costing all the taxpayers.
Betterment is only for new projects, it's not for repairs.
It's not for repairs or maintenance.
Wasn't Main Street going to be a new project or something you talked about last time?
West Main Street.
West Main Street.
West Main Street.
So we would pay for that.
We'll be going out, well, that's what, that reserve fund will hopefully help us with. We're going out for engineering bids.
$10,000 in engineering? That's what you're estimating?
To do preliminary so that we can come back with figures to town meeting.
But you can pull from this reserve fund for...
If we have an emergency, we can. We have to have upfront money, so if we do a project like West Main Street, it's just like the town when they do Class II State Aid Road Project. We pay for the costs and then get refunded. So the sewer commissioner, we do a project on West Main Street, we pay for the costs and then get refunded. So if there's no money in this account, you can't do the project because we can't pay for it.
Unless it's a developer. Unless it's a developer, I mean, there's no plans to just extend right now, right?
We're in the process, that's why you see an engineering figure. We're in the process.
And the advantage of doing the West Main Street line is now you'll have a whole lot of properties whose land value goes up.
What?
Now you have municipal sewer to tie into. That is...
How far?
Like your betterment you pay, it's a betterment to those lands, so the saleability goes way up.
Town water, so...
How far up do the lines go now to West Main?
To West Main?
Yeah.
The high school, and then there's a short line coming from town line back this way. We're trying to fill in that whole gap. You've got the old Turgeon property that's got some substantial acreage. All that whole strip there.
That's been for sale since I've lived in Tilton.
I understand you put sewer in there and you might find commercial, I'm not sure what the zone is, what's allowed, but if commercial's allowed...
It is.
You can be much better to market it because now you have sewer.
It's like I said, sewer to the...
Our town garage does not have sewer.
Right.
Those tanks are pumped.
So we pay to have the tank pumped multiple times a year.
Multiple.
And they didn't put in septic because they anticipated sewer. So what, 16 years we've been pumping that?
At the grid, water problems, the wetlands, and the water table's real high in there. You have to have sewer or a tank. You can't. We're stuck.
Why didn't they put a septic in there?
Because they anticipated sewer.
Oh,
in the 14, 15, 16, was there any betterment charges in those years that we're talking about that would come from us?
Betterments were switched quite a few years ago.
Three years ago.
So the answer is no, the betterments go.
So this reserve fund has really been building up after betterments then?
It's from fees. It's from, right. So there's... in 2018, there'd be enough to fund that project.
The state recommends that you have 5% of all your assets. That includes pump stations, pipes underground, all of that.
In the reserve fund?
Mm-hmm.
What would that 5% be?
I don't have a number off the top of my head. I can tell you 11 pump stations, you're looking at about $100,000 per pump station.
That's just the main ones. You're looking at least $5,000 for grinder pump stations. I've got 40 of those. I've got 13 miles of pipe that they generally estimate at $100 per foot. So I would say we're lower than what we should be and what we should have. It's not a requirement, it's what they recommend.
You're getting close. Very close. Could be right at 5%.
I'd say it's probably about 5%.
Yeah, yeah.
What's this? Your telephones, are those are the alarm lines?
Those are the alarm lines and my phone line for the office. We just switched to a new alarm system, so that cost is going to be going down.
390?
Yeah. Of what's on here?
Going down like over $2,000. That's a big...
Yeah, $2,800.
Yep.
Taking the last 3 years' actuals and then dividing it by three, the average is around $390,325 for budget.
Are you going to make a motion to go at that or around that?
I'll just bring it to the board first, see what everybody thinks.
You should keep in mind before you consider reducing the sewer commissioner's budget, it's like the maintenance repair line. Right now we have a station on Academy Street that is very old. Mm-hmm. I'm going to call it antiquated. It's in the middle of the road that we may have to replace.
But that's what your reserve fund was for, though, emergencies like that.
It's
not an emergency. That's
it's also been $100,000 under budget for 3 years. My question is, let's pad the budget again in case of emergency, in case we do this, in case we do this, in case we do this. Well, then why wasn't it done?
Now, do we have to vote on line items, or can we vote a bottom line?
Vote a bottom line on anything.
Vote a bottom line.
If you change the amounts, what does it do to our tax rate?
Nothing.
Yeah, he said they're from...
Revenues.
No taxation, other than the betterment, which hasn't happened in these last 3 years.
Oh, we're paying off the betterment, right.
Betterment comes through taxation.
Because we switched over to Silver Lake. So originally it was going to the users, and then 2 or 3 years ago,
do it through taxation.
They switched it back over to taxation, so that as opposed to having the sewer users pay for it, it went to all the taxpayers and spread out.
Whether you have it or not.
Whether you got it or not, yeah.
Yeah. Who made that vote?
The town. Legislative
the town.
Body.
Yeah.
It was a town hall, a town meeting. Anyone put that in the form of some form of motion?
What? Take betterment out?
No. We can't do that.
Back to the users.
You say go back to the users, but now you're also saying, gee, we don't want you to spend the money to extend the lines up Caleb, down West Main, and get more users. So you're not making sense.
Although those users would be paying.
Right.
All these years, we have money in there to do that, but it never got done. We never fixed it. My question is broad strokes. As a budget committee, how are we going to trim this budget to make it closer to actual? What line item, where it's used, what? And then the question is, well, why do you want extra? Well, in case of emergencies, or in case of a betterment, or this pump might fail.
And every
earthquake might happen.
Well, I mean, there's no long-range plan.
Get money budgeted if I have a major failure. If a pump station goes down, we have to fix it then. We can't wait 10 months to come before town meeting to ask to have the money appropriated.
But you have a reserve fund of...
Yes, but you're approving our budget, Jane.
I know what I'm... but that's where you would get it if you needed it. That's what you said when we had our first meeting. That if you had an emergency situation, that's where you would get it. We asked you what your plans were, and you didn't have any. You didn't have any specifics.
If we have to take money out of the reserve fund... If we have a station that goes down, fails. Let's say Academy Street fails. And we don't have enough money in our budget to repair it. We can't just take money out of the reserve fund. It's just like the town. You have to go to DRA, and you got to say, I got an emergency. I got to take this out. In the meanwhile, we've got raw sewage spewing into the streets or down here where we failed on River Road, right into the river. Into the we just had vandalism on Chapman.
What did you use for when that happened in the river?
Look at what happened to the fire bus.
We were able to use the money that's in our budget.
It's the same thing. They had to go back to DRA. DRA denied them when they went back for emergency funds. DRA denied them.
That wasn't coming out of the reserve fund, though.
If we have a failure, we have to have immediate monies to repair it. We cannot rely on this reserve fund. We have to go through the proper channels just like town does. That's there if there's a catastrophic emergency. You know, we have a huge failure here.
We're going to be expending.
Why don't we put into the police department budget an extra $150,000 in case of a gas leak and the police department blows up tonight? It's an emergency. Emergencies happen. Have an emergency. What do you mean?
You need a whole lot more than $150,000.
No, but that's what I'm saying is, how is that different?
Raw sewage. Flowing,
padding budgets for emergencies.
Raw sewage flowing to the surface.
Oh, I know, exactly.
Has to be fixed immediately.
Sure.
Can't wait for a meeting.
We
expend money for payroll, whatever monies we've got to fix that emergency.
And then take the money to...
No, then we have to go through a process of getting the money out.
I'm going to bring this back to the budget committee because we're just debating.
Well, I think the budget committee should learn more about the operation of the sewer. I mean, I really do. I've only been a sewer commissioner for a couple of years, and I can't believe what I learn every meeting all the time. It's not
we're
the
not
same
sewer commissioners. We're budget committee.
Yeah, we're budget committee making recommendations
on
the representatives of the residents.
I'm just suggesting that you learn more about what you're trying to do.
And 50 grand here, and 100,000 here, and 50 grand here, and 30,000 here.
We're going to fix it for next year.
It's easy to say yes.
We're going to come with a 10-year plan with costs.
That would be wonderful. I'd love to see that. We're the budget committee right now. It's not into the... We're working on the budget right now, so please.
Not open to public, Jane, is the word.
It's a flatline budget. I can't get over it.
I'm trying to help.
Well, that's why I'm like, why do we have to look at the lines? It's the bottom line.
Give you an understanding of where the money comes and where it comes.
Oh, yeah.
Doing.
But we don't have to vote on those.
Yeah, it's not our prerogative to tell them how to spend their money. And if that emergency happened, there would be money for them to fix it.
What we're making is a recommendation to go to the legislative body, so whatever we have, there would be the ultimate decision of the legislative body to amend or whatever we want, whatever they wish to do there.
And this is strictly bottom line, so.
On everything.
Yeah.
So you guys have to present to the legislative body?
No.
Vote?
No, it's part of the town budget.
This is the first year they presented to us.
Public is not open right now.
No, it's not.
But what we're task is to get this kind of information and give our recommendations so that they have an understanding that we're trying to do this. We could say on the entire budget, cut it by X percent. And then it's up to the selectmen and the managers of each department and everybody to just find ways to cut whatever that number is.
But if we cut, could they, at town meeting, say we want this budget?
Sure they can.
They can do anything.
So it's just recommendations.
That's all we're doing.
Our recommended budget's brought to the legislative body to decide on and amend as they see fit.
And the town, the legislative body, the town, is voting on our budget. Selectmen's budget is a suggestion of what they would like. Each department is a reasoning why they would like.
And we could get to town meeting and they could cut it to another $150,000.
It's also the selectman budget's a default budget. If we didn't produce a budget
that's why
in a timely manner or properly, then it would go back to the selectman's budget.
I can't see anymore.
My husband's probably saying, well, what's going on?
All right, guys.
Just somebody picking on me.
Yeah. Now you're going to pick a dark figure. Now you're going to pick a dark figure. I wish you'd scrutinize.
Pick a number.
I wish you'd scrutinize the police budget this close. I think next year we better up it by 50%.
Police budgets are easier to understand. It's not open to the public, but it
you
is
are explaining
easier
a lot better
to understand. You know, yeah. Not many people no, understand we would like the working
to,
of a sewer.
And we would like to see a 10-year plan. And
you're going to get one, and you're going to see rate increases included with it to pay for the cost.
I don't have sewer. I don't care.
That's on implementation.
Yeah.
10 years plans are just a plan. When
no,
you implement
we'll follow through with it, and in order to do it, we're going to need rate increases. So just be careful what you wish for.
Why? Just because you make a plan?
Well, sure. Why make a plan?
And it's like a threat. No.
Come on, let's get back to what we have to do here.
Can I just...
I've got a plan to save money.
For a second. Okay. Planned maintenance versus emergency. 2015, $6,193 was planned. $110,551 was emergency service. Okay? Unplanned.
Mm-hmm.
Is this on
wait, where?
This is 2015.
Oh.
You don't have it in front of you.
Oh, okay.
Today. 2016, we had $14,038 planned. We had $42,427 in emergency. And that number is way down because we just replaced two pump stations.
Okay.
Now, we've got Academy Street that's gone. I can tell you right now, we can't get parts for it anymore.
So you're trying to give us numbers that we don't have.
What I'm saying on that is that
emergencies
we can have plans and we can plan this amount of money. The amount of emergency, unplanned maintenance that comes up is going to be at least triple that amount every time. Every time. It just is.
Well, that
every holiday, I've got block pumps because people come to their house and flush non-flushables. It's just the way it is. Nature of the beast. It's sewer.
And it's a very old system, too.
It's a very old system. We've got pipes downtown. They stopped making that pipe material in 1970. 1970, they stopped making the material because that's when they found out it was junk. We have a huge amount of those pipes, Orangeburg pipes downtown. The remainder of the pipes downtown are clay. Clay pipes get cracks. We've got a ton of trees. They fill up with roots. Constant maintenance. Constant.
And that's why, like, a 10-year plan to replace some of those with newer infrastructure would be in order.
Absolutely.
And those maintenance numbers aren't on here? But $50 of advertising is? Postages? But we're ridiculous for asking these questions.
The budget committee has had versus unplanned?
No.
Well, we didn't know those numbers.
There's three of you that are sitting there that are not sewer users that are saying we have a maintenance plan so my bill can go up.
I think you should have a maintenance plan.
I definitely think there should be a maintenance plan.
Yes, you are.
Anything of light.
They talked about that a couple of meetings ago.
Now I'm irritated.
Welcome aboard.
I think one of the biggest things is, all the years I was on the budget committee, sewer department came to me and said, there's nothing you can do about this. This is a pass-through budget. You sign it and you pass it on.
Oh, I beg to differ.
That's what happened for years.
I have to argue with you. When I was ex officio...
And then that is what, point of privilege...
I explained to the budget committee that it wasn't passed through.
The budget committee has the floor at the moment, okay?
Yeah, well, I don't want to be disparaged.
And now, you know, now people are asking questions and...
These are the same type of questions we had with land use. Who's this? Who's that? Well, we don't have that info. I don't know, you know. I had a guy for $8,000-$9,000. Sure. Level fund it. They've given back, you know, they put money into the reserve fund, but...
So any suggestions on...
I suggest next year we not do them so late.
Well, we started early, so...
I know the public doesn't have the floor, but as a taxpayer, I found this meeting to be crazy on so many levels.
They all are. Join in. Sign up.
No, not on your...
Go for it.
Because you guys are not...
You come in once a year.
The public.
She can't. She's on the planning board.
Well, congratulations.
You want to make a motion?
Yeah, you're going to make one. Let's see. I make a motion to fund the sewer department the amount of $450,907.
I'll second that.
Can you repeat the number?
$450,907.
$450,907.
Yep. Is the second? John, you seconded it?
Yeah.
All in favor?
Any discussion?
I thought we discussed the hell out of it. Anybody want to have anything else?
$450.
Anybody have anything else to offer?
No, I don't even want to ask questions anymore, because our discussions turn into a public thing where people get to insult us on a regular basis for asking questions, and we're so stupid, we don't know every little detail. You're right, I don't know planning. I don't know sewers. I don't know about orange pipes. That's why when I asked the question, getting intimidated in this way, it's insulting.
Yeah.
Done with it. You wonder why you don't want to do it. You wonder why nobody wants to join these committees. Is this done on purpose? So that the same 12 people are on every committee? Is that why it's done like that? So we could throw in a $30,000 here at the end?
We have a motion on the floor.
My discussion is, why did you come up with that number?
I came up with that number because I don't want to cut them to the point that they aren't going to have money to do repairs and maintenance, and I came up with that because they've said that next year they will come up with a 10-year plan, which they haven't, but this is the first time they've appeared before the budget committee, and so for that reason, that's why I came up with that figure. That's reducing them by about, what, $12,000?
Which is engineering.
With an $800,000 reserve fund, approximately.
Yeah. Yep.
But it does, in fact,
sure,
count taxation, so there's no argument.
It's with user fees.
Yeah.
So it doesn't affect it. So that's why I would do that. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed?
Nay.
Okay. All right, is there any other business?
Can I just confirm, what was the vote on the $31,300? Was that 3-2?
4-1.
4-1.
4-1. And same here, 4-1?
Yes.
And your plan next year?
So we got vote.
I just have to say, I find this whole process of the sewer commission budget this year was absolutely bizarre.
It's the first time I've ever had anything explained.
But you've had the budget for over a month. And this was, I mean, this was presented, I mean,
He wasn't
you don't benefit from this in what, November? And here we are, last minute. You chose not to address it at any other meeting until right here, right down to the wire, and it makes no sense to me. I mean, Stan's absolutely right.
But we weren't asking off-the-wall questions. We're all we're asking is, how do you justify that? How do you justify that? And emergencies are not justification for padding a budget. Because that's the frustration is, we got ourselves an extra this equipment at $50,000. Where was that in the budget? Ah, it was so padded, you can add a $50,000 machine. Not the sewer did, or they aren't wasting money, but here, I could find 50 grand for a piece of equipment. It's ridiculous. That's my point earlier at the selectman part, is yes is easy. Saying no is very hard. Yes is easy. Sure. You want to raise? Double your salary. Sure.
I said no.
No, but you know what I'm saying? Yes is easy.
But that's why I'm saying.
I can't get attacked for being the only guy who says, why are we saying yes? Why do we keep saying yes? 400, 500, 500, but the actuals are in the 300s. Why is that? But I'm ridiculous for saying it?
No, no.
Nobody said you were ridiculous.
No, that's the reaction. The planning board lady who gets upset at me and says, oh, I need a copy of this. Yeah, get a copy. Email it to people. So maybe they could join these committees, too.
No, it's like I was saying. I've been
yes is easy.
And I can't get over how different this is than any of the other departments. Because you can't plan.
And this is the first time that we've gone over it.
Yeah.
And every other, we have the highway department has to have a 10-year plan. Everybody has to have a plan. And we are told there is none. And I don't think that's fair to a budget committee to ask them to do something when there's no plans.
They should have had one years ago.
Yeah.
But now most of the infrastructure's in, and there's only a little bit left.
No, but it's all
and
old.
Threatening
and
us that the plan is going
to. Made out of clay.
Maybe we need some new leadership is what we need.
All right. I'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
Motion to adjourn.
I'll second that.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed?
Yeah. 5-0.
Thanks, sir.